Hello, my name is Kent. This video demonstrates the Precision Matthews PM25MV milling machine and the excellent CNC conversion kit from David Clements of Arizona Video 99. A link to David's channel is in the video description. I've been using the converted mill for making parts for my business. If you'd like to see more examples, check out other content on my channel. I upload videos about my milling successes and failures regularly. Subscribe if you'd like to follow along. This Precision Matthews mill is from August 2014, and I received the CNC conversion kit from David during January of 2016. The installation of the kit only required a weekend. It simply bolted on without any modifications. The finish on the conversion kit is quite high. All the parts of the mill that needed to be removed were light and I could lift them solo. The electronics, LinuxCNC, and other general fiddling have taken a lot longer. The stepper motors I'm using are Leadshine ES-M32320 with ESD508 drivers on all three axes. The motors are NEMA 23 closed-loop stepper motors from Leadshine's Easy Servo line, with 283 ounce-inches of holding torque. These are smaller than what others are using on similar CNC conversions. However, I've not had a problem other than when I had over-tightened the angular contact bearings on one axis. I have roughly 1/1000 of backlash, but with LinuxCNC compensation, backlash is practically non-existent. This amount of backlash is better than my skill level. Also, when taking large cuts, the column head assembly seems to flex more than this, and as one learns their machine, workarounds are found for machine-related errors. To demonstrate that the small motors work fine, we can examine the following error from the Z-axis motor, which should be the hardest working axis. I've written software for doing this on Linux, but similar software is available from Leadshine for Windows. Also, monitoring the current delivered to the stepper drivers show they are not close to their current rating. The combined need for all three axes generally remains below 100 watts at 48 volts. In these graphs, the x-axis is time and the y-axis is the following error, or the difference between commanded location and actual location. The error is measured in steps, and there are 4,000 steps per revolution, and each revolution is 5 millimeters of travel. If the system was otherwise perfect, each step would be an absurd 49 millionth of an inch. Clearly, the following error is very low. The following error also quickly stabilizes near zero once an axis stops moving. If the following error grows too large or cannot be recovered, the axis stops and is treated by LinuxCNC as an e-stop. This is a warm-up routine that I run before milling parts. It simply exercises the axes. We'll run the program at various feed rates. feed rates in excess of what is reasonable are also possible. I believe even higher feed rates are possible if the acceleration is reduced. While higher velocities may be possible, there may be no point. Most of the mill's time is spent at much lower velocities. The higher velocities create a lot of momentum that has to be bled off by the motors. I hope this video is helpful to those planning their own CNC conversions or considering the Precision Matthews PM25MV milling machine and David's CNC conversion kit. While I have no hesitation recommending the mill or the CNC conversion kit, I'm not necessarily recommending that everyone use the smaller motors. More experience with them would first be necessary. After all, larger, generic motors are similarly priced. However, there are advantages of closed-loop motors worth considering. Thank you for watching, and I hope you'll be back for the next video.